Okay, I'm posting the second video because the first one didn't really show you it in its full glory. And as Lagerboy said, all good YouTube videos require a cat. So this is my drawer. The command station's in here. Wi-Fi connection's up the top there, and it just holds everything nice and neat. The power switch just in here to turn it all on. Once it's all on, you don't really need anything. There is a tether in there so I can program and everything like that using the USB there. Alright. We'll come around the side here, and these are just a couple of holding yards. Of course, my cat. I'll just bring it out to where it was yesterday. Okay. Okay, the first one I'll bring out is the 260, little shunter. Might be able to hear the Challenger chuffing away in the background there. And we'll put this one up in the transition loop, which is the two helixes. I don't know if I explained on the first video that everything is Wi-Fi'd. The throwing of the switches to the controlling of the train. This NCE Pro cab is actually quite a piece. Okay. Just get this one set in there. Into its loop, and I don't have to worry about driving trains into closed points. Okay, we'll now bring out the Challenger and we'll put it up on the top loop. Okay. First of all, I'll show you some sound effects. I'll turn on the light of the Challenger. And you'll be able to hear the steam turbine kick in, which is quite a feature. A blowdown. there's like a bit of a dead spot there. But... Alright, the next one we'll bring out is the FEF3 with the excursion set on it. It's quite a nice little logo. The Dalles, you see the scenery rises. I haven't cut them down yet, they're a bit extreme, but they'll be cut down to a correct size a little bit later. And we'll put the light on for the FFV3. Just go for a little bit of a wander so you can see the layout proper. Just do a couple of loops here and then I'll park everything. And just park the FE3. I'll bring the Challenger down. Thank you. squealing of the brakes. Reversing up. And then we'll bring back the low 6-0, 2-6-0. Swap that over. Just bring her back into a holding bay. And we'll park it beside the Challenger again. Comparison of size. Considering they're the same scale. Well, that's all about it. We'll just have a walk around so you can get a general overview of the whole lot. And how it all works in together. Once again, we can just shut it down by opening the drawer. And turning the power off. Plugging the controller back in. Bob's your uncle.